Hello everybody, this is Ivan doing a personal log for March 29th, 2012. Been a lot going on in the last month or so since I did my last update. First off, I've had a visit with my son and his fiance. They will be getting married later toward the end of the year. Very proud of my son, and he's got a beautiful young lady he's with, and just couldn't be happier about that. They'll probably be back down later this summer to visit again, and hopefully be coming through on their way to the Keys when they get married. So, also found out that I'm going to be a great-grandfather, which of course makes me feel incredibly old. However, that being said, I love little kids, so it kind of works out kind of well. Bless their hearts. Best wishes to them. A lot of stuff going on in my life. Like I say, the kids were here for a week, or at least my son and his fiance were. I've been playing with a new video toy, something called a streaming device, which allows me to bring video from the internet into my large TV in the house. That's been really enjoyable. Had a lot of fun with that. I had gone down to pick up a thing called a Roku, which is a small streaming device for under $50. And instead, I ended up with getting this little Sony device. It was a few dollars more, but it was designed specifically to work with YouTube. And of course, I spend a lot of time on YouTube, so I decided that the device would be better suited for me. So far, it has really worked great. So I've had a lot of fun with it and stuff. And once again, it has like the equivalent of channels. Like it has a thing called Crackle, which is it's movies and television and stuff. It's like a network, I think would be a better way to put it. And of course, I have the ability to stream off YouTube, which is a lot of stuff. It also has the ability to plug in a USB device, like a flash drive or a large hard drive, which is what I've been doing, is using it to play movies from a large hard drive. Overall, for the few bucks the thing cost, it's really worked well for me. My wife and I have recently decided to get rid of cable. We just don't watch it. We get about 30, 40 stations locally without cable, so. And so this, to me, was going to be a nice little device. Basically, you can use it to get Netflix and stuff, but if you don't want to, you don't have to. And so, basically, once you have the device, the operation is free. The downside of it, if there's been one, has been that it has a little remote control. And there's not, to the best of my knowledge, so much as an on-off thing on the box itself. So if you lose the remote control, you're basically doomed. You know, one of those for what it's worth sort of deals. At one point, the thing operates wirelessly off of your wireless router. And at one point, it just stopped acquiring a signal. I figured, well, now the thing's a dumb box. It won't do nothing. And what good am I going to get out of this? It also has the ability to plug into the Ethernet direct, wire it right into it. And so, just for the heck of it, I tried hooking it in direct to the Ethernet instead of using the wireless. And bang, the wireless started working again right away. So, if you have problems with such a device, you might want to try such an experiment. Just basically hardwire it into your router, and it may just snap back on you and work much better for you. But overall, I'd have to say I've been extremely pleased with the device. It allows me to bring YouTube and music and TV and movies into my home for free, by using the internet, which is something I already had. There's just a whole bunch of things going on in my life right now. I've been very lucky. My health overall and stuff has been very good, and my kids coming in and so on and so forth. I'm just really doing very well. I hope you're all doing as well. I did have a rather interesting conversation lately with family and friends that were around, and it went something to the effect, and I might note that I like to end these little sessions with kind of a question to whoever happens to be watching. So consider this as your question for the night. And it goes, the whole thing kind of goes like this. I was sitting with friends and family, and we had watched a movie or something on television. I don't remember what it was, but you've seen it 100 times before in science fiction in the movies where it's one person, whether it's Arnold Schwarzenegger or whoever it is, the hero is in the movie, and all they have to do is just give themselves up and be willing to die, and the whole world will be saved. Now, you know, we're not talking like one or two people. The whole world would be saved. Sorry about yourself, but the whole world would be saved. And I had a good friend of mine there, and they said, and they were so solemn, they said, I don't know, I'd have to think about that. And I just burst out laughing, because a long time ago, I knew I was willing to walk into a burning house to save one person, or reach into a burning car to save one person. So the whole concept of you're going to save the whole world just made me laugh. And I kind of cajoled him and said, you know, you'd have to think about that, huh? You're going to save the whole world. Can I think about that for a little bit? I don't know if I want to die or not. But it is the whole world, you know. And so I was kind of having some fun at their expense. And then my wife looked at me and she said, well, what if all you had to do was let me die? What would you think then? And you know, that kind of changed the whole thing. Suddenly I had a question in my head whether I would be willing to let her die to save the whole world. Kind of funny how we take things in life, isn't it? That, you know, some of us really, that whole self-sacrifice thing, maybe you could call it suicidal, I don't know. Most things I ever did were pretty cold and calculating. If I thought I had a good chance to survive, I took my chances, but the whole world, I mean. Anyway, so the question for tonight is, and I'll be curious to know what your opinions are, if you knew that God was going to zap you, bang, and in return the entire world would be saved from trials and tribulations, what would you do? Would you need a little time to think about that? Or would you just say, let's get this over with and kind of move on, you know? I mean, what the heck? And let's change it slightly. Think about that and answer that, and then think of it this way. Whoever you love in this world, take it for granted that you have somebody you love in this world, whoever the person is, your mother, father, son, daughter, whoever the person is you love the most in all the world, whoever that is, if you knew, you're standing right there talking to God, and God says, we have to sacrifice this one person to save the whole world. Would you try to interfere? Would you try to stop it? Or would you just think the whole world? Okay, that's my weird question for today. If all you had to do is just say, fine, I give up, would you turn yourself over? And if it was the most beloved person you have in the world, could you give them up to save the whole world? Wow, that's a really heavy question, isn't it? Probably not supposed to ask those on YouTube. I'll have to look over the whole rules thing to see if there's rules against really heavy questions. Anyway, Ivan, doing a personal log, March 29th, 2012. Thanks for watching. Best wishes to all of you. Hope you're all doing very well. Talk to you soon. Bye now.